To begin with, Caroline was tolerated. Then the government tried to silence it.
The pirate radio ships have no future at all. I'm quite convinced of that. And I think the sooner they're convinced of it, the better.
Pumping out pop music 24 hours a day, Caroline challenged existing broadcasting conventions and brought about dramatic changes.
If it hadn't been for Radio Caroline, we would have none of this, or the BBC would still be the light programme, and Mrs. Dell would still be turning her diary over. Can Bobby love?
When it all began, the Beatles were number one, the transistor radio was replacing the wireless, and Caroline was queen of the airwaves. North Sea weather finally achieved what the government could not, but 3 years later, Caroline was back. The station was founded by a young Irishman who chose the name after seeing a photograph of President Kennedy and his daughter. The headline said, Caroline plays and stops the government.
It was much more exciting then. I mean, there was much more adventure involved, and there was more amateur, if you like. It was more an amateur, instinctive thing, you know? It's a bit more professional now.
25 years on, in the age of satellite broadcasting, Caroline is still there, a defiant reminder of the days when the pirates ruled the waves.
And that's all from us for now. ITN is on the air throughout the night, but from me and from the weekend news team, have a very good evening.